inside you whisper, kid, don't sell your dreams so soon. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's a heart, there's a heart, a hand to hold on to. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's a face of somebody who needs you. Everywhere you look, when you're lost out there,
it's you again. Walk with me. Is this where I introduce? Okay. Hi, I'm Kunden. Kunden Rao. That's what Kunden. That's how you pronounce it. I thought I was supposed to do a lab right here, but I guess not. This is pretty awkward. My contract won't let me take it off for another 2 hours, or my family will get shot. But that's fine. So before we get started, does anyone have any questions?
I would like to point out that graph is very curvy.
Just like my women, all right? I'm sorry, that wasn't appropriate. Moving on. So here we have topic one, using attributes to graph and write equations of trigonometric functions from graphs. So right here, as you can see, we have a graph. So I'm gonna be explaining some stuff on the fly. That's kind of how I like to do things on the fly. So, yeah. So, here's pretty much the equation we're going to be using. Sorry, that Y kind of looks weird. But I'm going to try and do my best. I actually failed pre-cal in high school, so I'm not sure how this is going to go. I don't know why they hired me, but this is my equation that we're going to use here. So, A actually represents the amplitude. I'll just write that here. So you're also going to have a lot of attributes with this graph. You're actually going to have a period too. Okay, I need to explain these terms, dude. I can't do this. I need to have like set definition. No, stop recording. I need to have like a set definition. So A right here is represented by the amplitude, and the amplitude is actually the maximum extent of a vibration or oscillation measured from the position of equilibrium. Now, I don't understand that, so you probably won't, but that's fine. Moving on. This is the middle line right here. This is what you would consider equilibrium. So the amplitude is the distance from here to here in this example. So, I messed up. It's not from here, it's from here, because this is the middle.
It's okay.
Okay, what do I do? So the period from this graph is actually pi. So that would be the period of this graph. And if you plug that in, pi is equal to 2 pi over b. And you can just multiply this b, so times b and times b, and then you're going to get b times pi is equal to 2 pi. And you can just divide the pi's. And b is then equal to 2. Wow, I didn't know I'd get this far. Okay, so you have the average of the maximum and the minimum values, as you can see here. So I'll just go ahead and calculate that. 2 plus the negative 4 divided by 2 is equal to negative 2 over 2, which is equal to 1.
Bruh, look at this dude.
And this is how you calculate your d, because this is pretty much the average of the maximum and minimum values, and you're going to get 1. So this is going to be your d. Alright? So since the cosine function attains its maximum value at x is equal to 0, as you can see by the graph, it's inverted, which means we can either shift the graph by half a period, so pi over 2, or multiply the amplitude by negative 1. It would be easier to multiply it by negative 1, the amplitude by negative 1, when remultiplying the equation. So if I were to write all of this down, let me write this down in an orderly fashion. Okay, so amplitude is actually equal to 3, your b is equal to 2, your c is equal to... So it's kind of scattered all over the board here, but if I were to write this equation, y is equal to negative 3 cos 2x minus 1. I don't know what to do after that.
Oh, I didn't see you there. Alright, let's get started, shall we? So first we have your modeling word problems with sinusoidal functions. So we'll start off by a word problem. Do you have any suggestions?
Okay, I want to talk about the word sinusoidal. Maybe you don't know what it means. It comes from the Greek word sinusoid. It's like sigmoid, but the sinus. So yeah. Sinusoidal. You may continue.
Well, moving on. I like Ferris wheels, so let's start off with a carnival question. While at a carnival...
So I was editing the video, and no one wants to see Alvin riding the board, so... Here's some background music. Enjoy.
Rational function. I'm gonna take my function with no asymptote. I'm gonna divide till I can't no more. I'm gonna take that function with no asymptote. I'm gonna divide till I can't no more.
I got the functions in the bag. Exponent is attached. Font is matte black. Got the roots that's black to match. Riding on a function. You can't whip your function. I've been in the function, you ain't been up off that ration.
So while at a carnival, James Harden boards a Ferris wheel at a height of 6 feet above the ground, then the wheel starts turning at a constant rate. The function hox equals 17 plus 11 sine, parentheses pi over 12, parentheses x minus 6, parentheses, models the height, h, in feet that Harden is above the ground while riding the Ferris wheel for 48 seconds.
So as we can see from our word problem here, our amplitude is going to be 11. Our frequency is going to be pi over 12. Our phase shift is going to be 6. Our vertical shift is going to be 17, which is one of my favorite numbers. And the period is going to be 2 pi over b, which in this scenario is pi over 12. So you're going to multiply 2 pi over 1 by 12 over pi. The 2 pi's are going to cancel out, leaving you with my second favorite number, 24.
Now we're gonna start graphing. God! Alright, anyways. So. Oh, dude. Now we're gonna start graphing. So, since there's a phase shift of 6, we're gonna shift the graph to the right, which means we're gonna start at our minimum, which is 17 minus 11, which is 6. Then after that, we're gonna use the phase shift of 6 to go to the right, and now it's gonna be at our midline, which is 17. So, right here. Then, after that, we're gonna go another phase shift, which is 18, and add 11 to that. So that'll be 28. Then, you go back to the midline at 24, and then add more 6, so then it's 30, and now it's 30 and 6. And you see there's a common trend, is that there's this value and this value, the two minimums, and that is your period, which is 24, because it's 24 minus 0.
Wow, that was too bad. That was too hard, actually, now that I look at it.
That's what she said. Again.